right, back to the ball.
I know.
He's looking straight this way.
Try back, Dom.
Oh yeah.
Quick drop, it's coming. Drive it.
Oh yeah, oh, hey.
Nice catch. Good.
Oh. Nice catch.
Come on, two boogie. 2,000. Good D.
Oh, play
good.
Oh. Oh.
Hey, that's good D.
It's partially a gift from God. I really do believe it. A lot of athleticism stuff, but then you got to work your tail off to get to certain levels. And anytime you get someone like that in your midst that has worked their tail off to get to where they are, I think it's important to let them just share a few words of encouragement or share about their journey or whatnot, or whatever comes to mind. But I think I appreciate Garrett. If I clap it up real quick, it's good for him probably to get some work in. But if you're honest, it's one of those things that I think is a win-win because he gets a little work in while he's visiting his family, and we get to hang out with a guy who can sling a rock, which is fun and stuff. And he's living a little bit of a life that, you know, a lot of kids playing sports grow up dream of living, and very few get to. I think he's done it the right way, and respect that guy.
I would say to you guys, don't be afraid to make a mistake. And I was terrified of it, and it was hindering my play on the field. I was constantly, you know, worried about making a mistake. And then that's what you do. If you're worried about it, you're going to be out there making mistakes. And so that's one thing I would say. Just don't be worried about making a mistake. You guys can correct it, you know, Saturday morning or Monday, whenever you guys watch the game film. You guys can correct it then. Don't worry about correcting it in the game. You know, just another thing I would always say, I've got it tattooed on my chest. Quote my dad always told me, he said, don't ever leave somewhere saying you could have done more. And so that's something that's always kind of driven me, whether weight room or on the field, whatever it is, make sure you leave. It's as cliche as it sounds. I'm sure you've heard it from every coach you've ever had. Don't ever, you know, walk off the field with regret thinking you didn't leave it all out there, whatever it is, because there will come a time when you're done playing football, and hopefully, you know, you guys get, you know, 10, 15 more years and you get to play at the next level and the level after that, and you get to enjoy it. But, you know, just don't ever, that was something the seniors, my senior year of high school, I remember walking off the field with those guys and they all came up to me because I was the only one that was signed with the team to go on to play, and they all came up and said, you know, how jealous they were and how they wished that they would. Trying to brag on myself or anything, but they finally realized at that moment, you know, what they left behind and every little thing that they could have done to maybe get to play at the next level. And so don't be that guy that realized in his senior year, you know, walking off the field. So just try to enjoy it, because, you know, this is the best game in the world. There's no other game that requires this much teamwork and that many guys to be on the same page to win. You know, we make one guy makes one mistake in one play, that whole play can, you know, go to crap. So just work your butts off, enjoy it. It's the funnest game in the world, and it's the best game in the world. That's all I can really say about it. And, you know, just make sure you enjoy the whole process and enjoy high school. Shoot, those 4 years of your life, that's a special time in your life. So just enjoy every step and don't quit. Don't be afraid to make a mistake. That's all I can really say.